Hello and welcome to Ellen Ruth Soap. I'm Ellen and today I'm not making soap, I'm making bath bombs. Today I'm going to be making all natural bath bombs using my calamine powder for the kale and clay portion of my bath bomb. I'll leave the recipe in the description box below for what I'm doing today, but I want to make calamine powder bath bombs today. So this will not only be one of the main ingredients, but it will also be the colorant because it is this beautiful blushy pink color. Calamine powder is made up of zinc oxide and a touch of iron oxide. That's how you get this beautiful color, because iron oxide is a rusty red color. So anyway, that's what calamine powder is. It's not actually its own entity. It's a mixture of two things, but they have wonderful skin soothing benefits. Calamine lotion, calamine powder, great reputation. I encourage you to look it up and look at some of the skin benefits that you can get from a calamine powder facial. It's just really wonderful. And this is going to be all natural. I'm not going to use a fragrant oil today. I'm going to be using an essential oil of cedarwood, red cedar leaf essential oil. And this little essential oil that I got was a gift to me from Denise Casperson. She has a soap business in Canada. And she sent me the most wonderful gift basket of goodies, and I was so delighted to get it. I'm still using her soaps that she blessed me with. But anyway, they harvest and make this essential oil. So that will be what I'm using in these bath bombs along with the calamine powder. Cedarwood essential oil has a lot of really wonderful properties. It's relaxing, it's very soothing on your skin, and a whole host of other things. So I thought with the combination of the calamine powder, the cedar essential oil, these are just gonna be fantastic. So what I've got going on for the bomb, I am going to sprinkle down, I've got some pink rock salt, just because I thought that's really great in a bath. So I'm gonna put that in my mold. Today I'm gonna be doing my little disc molds. I got this mold from Kata Molds. So anyway, this is the little disc puck, and I just love these. They're easy to wrap because it has a flat surface for a label and easy to ship. They're very stable. I like my pucks better than my round bath bombs because the wrapping and labeling is easier. And it's still the bath bomb, right? Okay, so it doesn't have to be round. I'm doing a puck. So I will put a little salt in there, press the bath bomb in, and I'm going to be using my bath bomb press that I got from, let me show you the card here, Bath Bomb Express. This is my hand press, and I am loving it. Oh, let me get this out. It comes with a little unmolding tool and an Allen wrench. But anyway, I used this in an earlier video. It comes all in pieces, but they give you a step-by-step video how to put it together. It was very simple. This saved my wrists a lot of pressing. I really enjoyed using this press. So I will be pressing these bath bombs today using my hand press from Bath Bombs Express. And I am not affiliate with them. I bought this on my own. This was not a gift from them. I'm just telling you, I got it and I'm loving it. So I'm just sharing that information with you. That is it. I'm gonna get everything prepped, get my hair pulled back, get my whole work surface and all my equipment sanitized. And let's come back and make some really wonderful all-natural calamine bath bombs. All right, I'm back and I've got all of my work surface cleaned. I've got my safety gear, or not safety gear, but all of my sanitizing is done, and it's time to move forward. So what I'm going to start off with is my citric acid here. I get it in bulk, and I'm going to measure off 30 ounces of citric acid and set it off to the side while I get the rest of my dry ingredients ready. I like to add the citric acid last after I get the wet and the dry ingredients all mixed together so that I don't activate, because this is what makes that wonderful fizzy business going on in your bath bomb. So 30 ounces. A normal rule of thumb for citric acid in a bath bomb is a 1-to-2 split. Sorry, I can't talk while I'm measuring. Let me get this topped off here. All right, 30 ounces. So normally, like if you have 2 cups of baking soda, you'd have 1 cup of citric acid. So like a 2-to-1 ratio. Well, I like to go a little heavier on the citric acid. It makes it extra fizzy, and I like that. So we're gonna do 47 ounces of baking soda and 30 ounces of citric acid today. So there is the citric acid, and it's all off to the side. Now, I am going to measure the rest of my dry ingredients in this bucket, and then I will sift it into my mixing bowl all together, just to help me with my hand mixing of this. So I'm going to tear this out, and I need 47 ounces of baking soda. And I buy these big bags at, you can get them at Sam's Club, Costco, Walmart, all those places. At Walmart in the summer months, they're over by the swimming pool supplies. You can find it, but it is kind of, I don't know if you can see in there, it's very chunky, and that's one of the reasons why I like to run it through the sifter. Look, it's super chunk. So 47 ounces. There we go. Oh, that's 48 ounces. Let's go. There we go. Close enough. 47 ounces of baking soda. And now I'm going to do 2 ounces of cream of tartar. There is my cream of tartar. This is a caking agent, and it helps make your bath bombs really rock hard. And it's, you know, it's very soothing, cream of tartar, but makes for a nice hard bath bomb. So 2 ounces. Go. And now I'm going to do 2 ounces of my calamine powder. It is such a pretty color, and this will be the only colorant in here. I'm hoping a little bit of that gorgeous pinky blushy will come through. So 2 ounces of calamine. There we go. Wonderful. And now I need 1 ounce of SLSA. And you want to make sure that you have your mask on for that, because it is very light and fluffy and it will irritate your nose and throat. And nobody wants that. So let me tear this out. And I got this SLSA from Be Scented. They had a really good sale going on, so that's where I got this. You can get it from many distributors. So 1 ounce. And here's a word about SLSA. Some people don't like it. If you have a sensitivity or you don't like it for some reason, you can omit this. You don't need this in your bath bomb. It just makes a really nice kind of bubbly situation. I think it makes a beautiful, foaming, luxurious feel to your bomb. There we go. All right, now we have all the dry ingredients already. So here is my handy dandy. I like to use a metal stainless steel sifter so I can sanitize it and clean it really well. I don't like to use plastic ones if I can avoid it for my crafting. It's just a preference. You can if you want to, but I like this because I feel like I can get it really scrubby clean. So now I'm just going to run everything through my sifter a little bit at a time until I get it really well, because look, that's the baking soda. You know, that's obnoxious. So I kind of break it up a little with my hand, and then I have my spoon over here, mash it through. Boy, this baking soda was really chunky today. So anyway, I'm just going to run all the dry ingredients through here, and then we will get to mixing our liquid ingredients and get to mixing up our nice bath bomb mixture. This is all sifted and ready to go, and now it's time for the wet ingredients. And I have 1 ounce of my essential oils here, and I didn't have enough cedarwood essential oil. I had about half an ounce, so I put some tea tree oil in here. So this is a combination of cedarwood and tea tree essential oils. I thought that sounded like a really nice combo. So I've got that teared out, and now I'm going to add 1 ounce of witch hazel. I like to use witch hazel. And I also have my misting bottle off to the side. You don't have to use witch hazel. You could use rubbing alcohol. You could use distilled water. I like witch hazel for the skin benefits. Today for my light oil, you want 1 ounce of oils. You could use a combination of oils, but I like a nice light oil. Today I'm going to be using grapeseed oil. I have this non-GMO grapeseed oil, and that just sounded really nice to me. So 1 ounce of oils. All right, and last but not least, a half an ounce of polysorbate 80. And the poly 80 is your emulsifier. That's what's gonna, if you did have micas in here, which I don't today, but if you did, it would emulsify with that, it would emulsify with the oils, and it keeps you from getting that ring around your tub or from a slippery bottom. So this is your emulsifier, which I really highly recommend. So we need a half an ounce of poly 80. There we go, not much, just enough. And that is it for the wet ingredients. All right, now it's time to add the wet ingredients. Here's my little spritzer, I had it off to the side. This has witch hazel in it in case this is too dry, and I just spritz that as needed. So here is my little liquid cocktail that we're just gonna get this really well and incorporated in here. And once it's very blended in, then I will add my citric acid as the last step. And then we'll test it for, give it the squish test and see if it's at the consistency we want. So while I'm talking about that, let's talk about consistency. And I said you could leave out the SLSA. You can, but then it's going to be a little bit low on the dry ingredients. So anytime you wanna play with, like if you don't want the SLSA in there, you're taking away a dry ingredient. You can add a little more, or you can go a little shy on your liquids, or amp up your baking soda or your cream of tartar just by a little bit, you know, just to make up for that volume. So you have a little bit of wiggle room there with these, and I would say just take this recipe and cut it in half and then cut it in half again and test around and find what you like for your area. I've heard other bath bomb makers say this, and I will just amen what they're saying, which is if you ever see somebody saying the perfect bath bomb recipe, I actually don't believe there is such a thing because everybody's climate is different. I have a massive dehumidifier going over by my curing racks and I set my bath bombs right next to it because I live in a very humid climate. If you're in Colorado making bath bombs, it's gonna be a different experience than making them here in Middle Tennessee versus making them in Miami, Florida. So. There are some great guidelines to bath bombs, but I don't think there's any one absolute perfect ratio for every single climate. So, you know, a little bit of wiggle room, which is why a lot of people will keep their spritz bottles of liquid off to the side, because sometimes you need to add a little more. And even not just, you know, where you live, but the season that you're making it. If I've had a bunch of rain, and it's particularly, you know, wet outside, or if I'm making these in the middle of winter, all of those things factor in. So just saying, and it's bath bombs, you're not working with costing materials, so it's okay to wiggle around and play around with it and see. And I said this in an earlier bath bomb video, if you make your whole bath bomb mixture and your bombs just aren't sticking together, this is still wonderful. Well, after I put the citric acid in there, you know, just use it as bath sprinkles. You're not wasting anything. So have fun, play with it. See what works for you and your area. All right, this is really well and incorporated. I feel like there's no standing wet ingredients, so I can go ahead and add my citric acid now and it won't activate. There we go. And we'll get this blended in really well, and then we will give it the little squeeze test. And that's when I take a bit and I squeeze it and see how it holds up. That's what I call a squeeze test. Oh, this is a really pretty color. It's very, just kind of a baby pink. That calamine pink is really pretty. And I think this pink rock salt in there is gonna look, just kind of go with the whole theme. I think these are really nice. But I will say the cedar and the tea tree is not a feminine fragrance, so even though these are pink, I would say these are definitely unisex. If you are a dude with itchy skin, don't shy away from the pink. Even though I ran this through the sifter, every once in a while, I'll still see like a little white speck of baking soda clump in there. So that's what I'm keeping an eye out for. I want this blended as well as I can get it. That is looking really good. It's very loamy, kind of feels like damp sand right now. So I'm gonna take a little bit in my hand and give it a squeeze and then open my palm up. And if I can bop this around and it doesn't fall apart like that, it's good to go. I'm very happy with this. So I'm not going to spritz any more liquid on here. I think it feels great. So with that being said, let me get my press over here and get set up. I've got my scale. What I'm going to do today is measure it out on the scale because I want these all to be relatively the same weight. So I will tear that out and I'm going to throw down just a little bit, not a ton. I don't know. Let me just see how that looks. Yeah, about like that. And I kind of want it on one side. So I've got it kind of bopped up to one side. And now I'm going to pack in. I'm going to do about 3 to 3.5 ounces of bath bomb mixture in here. That's 3.2. There we go, 3.5 ounces. So let me scoot this out of the way and get my fabulous hand press over. And so this is 3.5. I'm going to go ahead and press this out and see how I like it. And if that's the size and everything I want, then we will stick with that. So I don't flip this. I just kind of rotate it and just go a couple of times. I'm not putting a ton of pressure. There we go. Oh, pretty. I love how the salt looks. We'll push up and take it out. And there is the perfect little bath bomb puck. I am loving it. All right. All pressed and looking gorgeous. I got 23 3.5 ounce bombs and one little sample one here that we're going to give a try with out of this recipe. So it smells great in here. I love the medicinal smell of tea tree and everything. So here's my little 3 ounce one. It wasn't quite as big as the others, but let's give it a whirl and some warm water. Again, and I just pressed these. So let me just tell you real quick before we get on with the bubbling factor here. I'm going to let these sit out overnight, about 12 hours. I'm going to flip them on the rack, let them sit like that for another 8 to 12 hours, and then they'll be ready to wrap. So let's give it a try.